Hello everyone, welcome to the first video of a series about the creation of this image that you're watching here, which I called Naval Scene, or Naval Battle, just because it's a clash between two ships. Now this is the final result, and I'm going to show you how I kind of got there. I knew I wanted to do another image with ocean and ships, so I started by sketching a couple of ships in very simple sketches. These aren't even thumbnails. These are just like taking notes on a piece of paper as I'm on the phone or as I'm, you know, not doing anything specifically. And there's a corner of the page that hasn't been drawn in yet. So I go in and I sketch what I'd like to see. For example, in this case, you can see that I drew a big canvas and then decided that I might just want to see a tiny bit of that image. This one is a very good down angle. There's another different perspective. The perspective is a bit messed up in here, but that's not the point of these sketches. You can see that I make a note there for the ripping of the front sail. There's a test of perspective here. Maybe have some waves go up and down. I was thinking of having the camera, quote unquote, partially submerged. And those kind of led to these better thumbnails, which are a little bigger than the screen, so let me just fit those in a little better. And these thumbnails are more definitely looking for something. So I started by doing a lot of sketching. I just basically did them like this in columns. The most peculiar one is this. It's almost like if there was a flying camera from the side of the ship looking across into the other ship. But that is just very complicated composition. This one was interesting, but I couldn't make them shoot each other unless it had cannons at the front, which I don't think is very usual. So I always had to have the ships in kind of a battle position so that they could sort of reach each other. And eventually went on and on and on until I reached these final two, which are the most the closest to the ones that I have in the end. I did a couple of shading and color tests. This was basically to see if I would like to see the shade, the shadows on the water. This as well, a very simple watercolor test, and that led to creating this watercolor color key, which is basically a very blue sky and a Caribbean water, very greenish, which is something that I sort of decided I didn't want. Also, the ships are the one on the left looks a lot smaller because the perspective is wrong. They look to be at the same level. So it should be a little bit higher, close to the horizon line to look like it's further away. But again, the purpose of this was just to establish color. I really like the way that the reflected color ended up on the ship. And this is kind of accidental. I mean, there's a lot of accidents happening when dealing with watercolor, especially if you're not really, expert with it, which is I am not. I've started doing watercolor for like 3 months. And so it's cool to see that these effects happening naturally, and that led me into wanting a lot more things for the image. So if you really want to see how the image was made now practically in pixel art, just go ahead and watch the rest of the videos. Thank you so much. Take care.